हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे माय टॉपिक इज क्यूए और टेस्ट मैनेजर इंटरव्यू क्वेश्चंस एंड आंसर पार्ट 3। फ्रेंड्स, आई एम क्रिएटिंग ए सीरीज ऑफ क्यूए टेस्ट मैनेजर इंटरव्यू क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर। दिस इज द पार्ट 3। आई विल प्रोवाइड द लिंक ऑफ द पार्ट 1 एंड पार्ट 2 इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन सेक्शन ऑफ दिस वीडियो फ्रॉम वेयर यू कैन वॉच। फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन दीज 5 इंटरव्यू क्वेश्चन विद देयर आंसर। द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज What are the different tools or application used by your team? Question 2. Give me an example when you work in a very high pressure environment. Question 3. What motivates you to get up in the morning to come to work? Question 4. If we select you, then what will be your plans for next year? What initiative you will take? And the last question is, What is the role of test manager and test lead in the agile project? So let's start one by one. The first question is, what are the different tools and applications used by your team for testing? Friends, by asking this question, employer wants to see that are you familiar with the latest tools, trends and the applications? Before giving the answer of this question, please keep the following points in your mind. First one, you must have to show that you are familiar with manual tools as well as the automation testing tool. And your answer must be like this. We are using so many tools, we can divide the tools into two sections, manual and automation tools. For manual, we are using the following tools or application. First one is the TestLink. TestLink is an open source test management tool used for project management, bug tracking and the test management. You can write the test cases over it and you can execute. Second, Redmine. Friends, Redmine is an open source and free web-based project management and issue tracking tool. With the help of it, user can manage multiple projects and associated sub-projects too. Third, TestCase Studio. TestCase Studio is a free browser plugin that records all the user action performed on a web application in plain English sentences so we cannot miss any step. 4. Jira. Jira is a software application used for issue tracking and project management. 5. Postman. Postman is also an open source manual API testing platform where we can test the API manually with the help of Postman. 6. JMeter. JMeter is an open source load and performance testing software. With the help of JMeter, we can do the load testing as well as the performance testing. Last one is the BrowserStack. BrowserStack is a cloud-based testing tool. We can do cross-browser testing of various web or mobile application in different web browser and in different versions too. For automation testing, we are using the four tools or application. First one is the Selenium. Friends, Selenium is an open source tool to automate web application. Second, Selector Hub. Selector Hub is a free to use browser plugin extension that helps auto suggest all the possible combination of attributes, text, sibling, etc. to build selectors within the second. Third one is the APM. Friends, APM is an open source tool used to automate mobile application. Fourth, Cypress. Cypress is a JavaScript based tool used for front-end testing. Fifth is Jenkins. Jenkins is an open source automation server. We can create a pipeline to facilitate continuous integration and continuous delivery. That's why it is called CI/CD tool. Next one is the GitHub. Friends, GitHub is a version control tool. Cucumber. Cucumber is a testing tool that supports behavior-driven development approach. Next one is the BrowserStack. BrowserStack is a cloud-based testing tool. We can do cross-browser testing of various web and mobile applications in the different web browser and in different environment. Next is the Extend Reports. Extend Reports is an open-source reporting library used in automation testing. We can integrate it with the major testing framework like JUnit and Unit Test Engine, etc. The last one is the REST Assured. REST Assured is used to automate the APIs. Let's move to the next question. Question is, give me an example when you work in a very high pressure environment. Friends, by asking this question, employer wants to see how you perform and think under pressure. So before giving the answer to this question, please keep the following points in your mind. First, you must have to show that you can perform very well under pressure. Second, you must also have to give the example that have you handled that particular situation, and you also have to tell them that how you use the STAR technique. And your answer must be like, in one of my previous projects, the client added a few new features just before the final test execution, which requires a lot of extra work. I used the STAR method to resolve it. Now friends, what is STAR method? In STAR method, S is basically for situation, T for task, A for action, and R for result. So let's explain one by one. First one is the situation. What kind of situation was there? How I performed for that? Firstly, under situation, I understand what was the problem and how it came up. In my case, problem was client added a few new features just before the final test execution, which requires a lot of extra work. So this is the situation. Now move to the next task. We, me and my team discuss the task that we have in hand and the new task in the pipeline. Third one is the action. What action we have taken? I divided the team into two parts and asked half of the team to start the test execution. The rest team worked closely with business analyst to understand the new requirements and start preparation of the new test cases. I was coordinating with the client and the monitoring the process. I have also written a few test cases whenever required. We collaborated with the business to receive early feedback on the test cases and the test execution so we can do the smoke test first. So now come to the result section. Me and my team worked smartly and achieved the goal on time. New functionality were added successfully and the client was very happy. So you have to use STAR method whenever you face some this kind of issues. Now let's move to the next question. Next question is, what motivates you to get up in the morning to come to work? Friends, by asking this question, employer wants to see that your dedication and willingness to work. Before giving the answer of this question, please keep the following points in your mind. First, you must have to show that you love your work. Second, you also have to show that you are learning new things every day. And your answer must be like, for me, there are lots of factors that motivates me to get up in the morning to come to work. Few are. First, take up new challenges every day that enhance my problem solving skill. Second, learn new things every day. Third, working and coordinating with my team players. Fourth, great sense of achievement after work. And last one is the satisfaction that we, me and my team are on the right track to achieve our goals related to the projects. So these are the things that motivate me to wake up early in the morning and come to the work. Now let's move to the next question. Next question is, if we select you, then what will be your plans for the next year? What initiative you will take? Friends, by asking this question, employer want to see that you done your homework about the current profile or not. They want to see how futuristic you are. Before giving the answer of this question, please keep the following points in your mind. First, you must have to read the job description very well. Second, you must have to showcase that you are coming with a pre-plan for you and your team also. And your answer must be like this. First, I will check the current testing process followed by the team and will see how I can use my experience to enhance it. Second, I will understand the current testing environment and will find if there is any scope for improvement. Third, I will do one-to-one with the team members to understand the pain areas and will work on these pain areas. Fourth, I will work on the testing framework so every team member can understand it. Fifth, I will also work on automation strategy so I can improve the process of testing. And the last one is, I will also work on the test skill matrices of the team members so I can identify the gaps in the skills and arrange training to them. So these are the my plan. Last question is, what is the role of test manager or test lead in agile project? Friends, by asking this question, employer wants to see that how much familiar you are with agile. What do you do in an agile project? Friends, your answer must be like this. In agile, we deliver the small features of the software in short intervals called sprints. Testing activities are done in parallel with development. Tester needs to collaborate with all the team members to quickly understand and deliver the feature. Role of test lead or test manager in agile projects are, first, test lead or manager helps the team to ensure product quality by having a strategic and well-planned approach of testing. Second, test lead or manager helps to drive the continuous improvement effort from the testing perspective as a whole. Third, test lead or manager responsible for personal support, mentoring and professional development of tester. Fourth, test lead or manager support in testing communication within and outside the team. And the last one is, the test lead manager is also an exclamation point if the tester feels they are not able to maintain their test independence in the team. So friends, these are the 5 questions I have explained in this video. Friends, if you like my video, please like it, comment it and share it with your friends. Friends, don't forget to subscribe my channel. If you subscribe my channel, then you will get the notification of the next video that I am going to upload on my channel. Friends, if you have any doubt or any other question, then you can write them in the comment section of this video. I will try to reply as early as possible. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.